Hey, it's Mike Chen. Thanks so much for watching Beyond Science. In this video, we're going to talk about some of the Beyond Science-y news items from last week. And we'll start off with this one. A few days ago, NASA's Van Allen probes, which are designed to study electrons and ions in space, reported that there is actually an artificial barrier surrounding Earth created by none other than, well, us, and we didn't even know we were creating it. This artificial barrier was the result of low-frequency radio communications created by human activity. Very low-frequency signals, or VLF, are often emitted by radio telescopes that have the task of contacting submarines in the ocean. But while most of the signals are sent down into the deep, dark waters, some signals also float into the atmosphere, resulting in something called a VLF bubble that surrounds the Earth. The VLF bubble extends all the way to the inner edge of the Van Allen radiation belts, which are three belts that have energetic charged particles held by Earth's magnetic field. The interaction between the VLF bubble in the radiation belts results in the artificial barrier that we're talking about. Phil Erickson, one of the scientists involved in the discovery, said, "A number of experiments and observations have figured out that under the right circumstances, radio communication signals in the VLF frequency range can in fact affect the properties of the high energy radiation environments around the Earth. In fact, if the VLF bubble did not exist, then we would be much closer to the radiation belt than we currently are. As shown in data from the 1960s, the Van Allen radiation belt was actually much closer to Earth back then than it is now." And I'm sure you're wondering right now, so what does this barrier actually do? Well, it's not going to protect us from a runaway asteroid or an alien proton torpedo attack, but the barrier is actually protecting the Earth from space radiation. Not only that, researchers also say that this barrier will be able to shield us from other dangers like coronal mass ejections, which are explosions that occur on the sun that may result in geomagnetic storms that can destroy communication satellites and power grids, as well as affect the weather in space. And scientists are now saying that the barrier could also potentially remove excess radiation around the Earth and are carrying out experiments as we speak. Next, moving away from man-made barriers and onto the topic of aliens. Because, you know, they are interconnected. A report over the weekend has announced that one of the strangest stars in the universe, the KIC 8462852, yeah, I know, long name, also known as Tabby Star, has started behaving very strangely again. And if you don't know about Tabby Star, I did a video on this before, so I'll link that in my description box below. But this star, nicknamed the Alien Megastructure Star, was originally discovered in 2009 and is located 1,500 light years away from Earth between the Cygnus and Lyra constellations of our Milky Way galaxy. This star is called the Alien Megastructure Star because in late 2015, astronomers led by Tabitha Boyle-Jing, aka Tabby, discovered that the star was emitting light in a very strange pattern. To give a little background info, stars usually emit light in very slight dips of less than 1% every few weeks, days, or months. But to the astronomers' surprise, Tabby Star was emitting light dips of up to 22%. And the strange thing was that the light dips didn't follow a particular pattern either, which left astronomers and scientists completely baffled. No one had a clue what was going on and could think of no explanations as to why the star was behaving the way it was. As a result, one researcher offered the possibility that an alien megastructure was messing with the star, which is how it got its nickname, Alien Megastructure Star. According to Jason Wright, Associate Professor of Astronomy and Astrophysics at Penn State, the star started dimming again last Friday and has already dimmed by 3% in a matter of a few days. He immediately tweeted about the phenomena on Twitter, which caused everybody in the astronomical community to basically freak out and run for their telescopes. According to astronomer Matt Muttersbaugh from Tennessee State University, far as I can tell, every telescope that can look at it right now is looking at it right now. Now, the reason why this second dimming of the KIC 8462852 is so important is because it allows researchers to gather more data about its bizarre dip patterns. During the last dipping in 2015, astronomers were not able to collect enough data to provide reasonable explanations about the strange star's light patterns. According to Boyle-Jing, "We were kind of stuck in a spot where we couldn't do anything. We had all the data we could, and to learn anything more, we needed to catch it in action again." Of course, people are still considering the possibility that it is aliens at work here. In fact, this star is one of the few phenomena where no one has even discounted the aliens yet. That's how weird this is. Jason Wright even said that aliens should always be the very last hypothesis you consider, but this looked like something you would expect an alien civilization to build. In fact, Wright believes that the star's irregular light emission is caused by something like the Dyson sphere we see in sci-fi movies, a huge alien sphere created around the star that surrounds it and absorbs all the energy output of the star so that life forms can live on the star's surface. And regarding Wright's theory about the Dyson sphere, Matt Muttersbaugh says that theory is still a valid one. We would really hate to go to that because that's a pretty major thing. It'd be awesome, of course, but as scientists, we're hoping there's a natural explanation. I'm gonna disagree with Matt there. Why, as scientists, do you hope there's a natural explanation? Wouldn't it be the greatest scientific find ever if we found out that, 1500 light years away, there's an alien civilization basically sucking the energy dry of a planet? It'd be a great discovery. It'd also be kind of freaky because if they can do that to that planet, they can come over here and do it to us. And hopefully it won't lead to a war of the worlds kind of thing. But guys, let me know what you think. Do you think aliens actually built a huge Dyson sphere around KIC 8462852? Yeah, it just rolls off the tongue, doesn't it, that name? If not, why do you think the star is dimming? All right, guys, thank you all so much for watching this video. I'll see you later.